Welcome to the PageFly video tutorial series. In today's video, you'll learn about how to use product list element in PageFly. The product list is designed to present a list of products on your page in order to increase your conversion rate. You can use the product list element to upsell and cross-sell your products by assigning it to a specific collection of products. You can find this element at the left toolbar. Click Add Shopify element here. And product list element is the first one. There are three options for displaying this element you can choose. In this video, I'm gonna choose the second option. And I'll drag and drop it onto the page editor. And then, go to the General tab. Under the content parameter, you can see product source, which gives you three options to display your product list. If you want to show all products in your store, choose all. If you want to show products of a specific collection, choose custom collection. And if you want to show products relating to a specific product, choose related products. I'll click the custom collection option. In the custom collection option, click plus sign here, and you can choose the collection you want to show. I will choose this collection, and then click select collection. And now, you can see some options that help you customize your product list. With items per loading option, you can change the number of products shown on your page. Note that you can only show a maximum of 20 products. This is limited by Shopify. If you want to show customers more products, scroll down to the loading mode option, choose pagination or load more. The pagination option will be displayed as the page's numbers. Customers can click on these numbers to see other products. Load more option will be displayed as load more button. Customers can click on the load more button to see other products. Keep in mind that these features only work on the live page. You can also adjust the number of items in a row with items per row option. I recommend that it should be only from 2 to 4 items on each row, which helps to show product details clearly. Also, you can adjust space between items with the item spacing option. And now I'll click on one product image. Go ahead the General tab. Under Default Image Source, there are two options to show product image. Featured image allows you to show the first image you set in the product category on the Shopify dashboard. The first variant image option allows you to show the image of the first product variant you set in the product category on the Shopify dashboard. You can also set fixed height to change image height, set up hover action, click action and show image list, show badge as well. Here I am setting show hover image, which will switch the next image when you hover it. And link to product, which will direct to the product page when you click on the product image. And show image list. You can also customize the product elements such as product title, product price, add to cart button by clicking on each element. Back to product list element. I'll click the product list on breadcrumbs. And then go to the styling tab. Styling tab allows you to customize the content color, paddings, margins, typography or background of product list. Note that, when you change the content color of product list, all content color of product elements will be changed. If you want to change the content color of one product element, you need to click this element on the page editor and then change the content color. If you want to add more elements to product details in the product list, go to the left toolbar. Click Add Shopify element. And you can see so many elements under product list element to add. You can choose product price element, add a compared price. Or add a product variant element if you want. And now I am gonna switch to mobile view and see how this product list shows. You can see the items per row are automatically set for 2 items. And this automation makes the mobile view more clear. You can still change this setting with item per row element on the General tab. Sometime, when you switch to mobile view, you can see the add to cart buttons are not aligning, like this. In this case, you just need to add a new product list element. And the buttons will be aligning. You have so many products and in many cases, you may want to change the product order and product list to show the newest products. We have had a video tutorial about changing the product order in a product list. I'll put it in the description of this video. Now, you can save all changes. Click Publish, and then Live View to see your live page.
This is the end of the tutorial. If you find this video helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel for more helpful future content. Don't forget to leave us any questions in the comments section below, or reach us via our 24/7 in-app live chat for further assistance. To learn more about PageFly, check out other video tutorials and visit our help center. Thank you for watching. See you next time.